Hey guys, it's Sonia with Junk Monkey Paint Company, and boy have I got a room reveal for you guys today. You have been patiently waiting to see what this room looks like. You've been with me from the beginning, from when we ripped up this nasty brownie frowny for sure carpet, stained carpet. We purchased this house in the last few months, and it was built in 1890, and under that awful carpet was this beautiful hardwood. So right here you can see that I have stained half this room so far in order to leave space for the other side. I kind of did it in parts. And so this vanity built-in shelving over here on this side, Matt was like, we could rip it out. And I'm like, can we save it? Let's see the power paint, what it can do. So I went first of all to Walmart and found this reusable, repurposable wallpaper. It stuck on. That was a quick 30-minute makeover. Then this blue countertop and the shelving itself. So what I did was put on a nice coat of sandy tan toes. I didn't have the primer sander strip. You guys know that went right over the hardware even. And I also put down a layer of candy bar brown on the blue countertop itself. I had to hide that. So if you can see in this video here as it pans across, on top of that candy bar brown chalky style paint, what I did then was put over a nice coat of Minwax poly shades in a color called Mission Oak, which gave this piece a really nice dark wood look. Oh my gosh, love how it turned out. Look at the floor. You'll see at the very end of this video here as I pan across, you'll see that brown countertop right there. Doesn't it look absolutely gorgeous? Totally changed up the space just doing those two things alone. All right, and here we go. Here's a quick room spin for you, and then we'll go ahead and we'll talk about all the things that came to be able to bring this space together. I am positively in love. Yes, I got lots of little things to do like odds and ends, but for the most part of it, this space is complete. And I'm very, very happy. Doesn't it look completely different, guys, with, you know, what it looked like before? All right, so I found this lamp right here at Pier 1 just last week. Got it for $11.99. It was like $100-odd lamp on sale. Hello. It was one of their demo lamps, so I thought that was pretty cool. Got lots of pillows. The bedding came from Marshall's, which I really liked. Got that on sale. And got an entire, like, coordinating pillows, shams, comforter, all of it, I think, for, like, $29. This cactus prized canvas art was also an over $100 piece that I got on sale for like $12 or thereabouts as well. Could not believe it. Always check the clearance sections. That is where I go first. This beautiful rug with a print on it came from a place called At Home. I loved it. I wanted to bring in a lot of neutrals into this space because the floors are so dark and I really wanted to lighten up. We've got lots of just beautiful wood throughout this house, so that's why I decided to go with some light colors. This chair came from Goodwill. Look at this beautiful Queen Anne style, old style chair. Loved it. Hello, love my cactus print too. I affectionately call this the cactus room. You guys can probably figure out why. I got these two prints in the clearance section at Kirkland's. Those cactus pillows, you can see there's two of them, they came from Walmart for $2.50 a piece, including, you see how the curtains match the rug? Those, that set also came from Walmart for about $12. I like the fact that they filter the light. They're not, you know, completely sheer. The middle panels came from At Home as well. And again, it just kind of makes the room feel just really, really cozy, and it lets light in. Doesn't completely block it, so I love that about it. The pillow came with the bedding. I think I got these last two pillows right here because you can never say it with me. Have enough candlesticks or pillows over at Gabe's. This stand, I actually have a vlog how to do this. You guys watch me flip this little sofa table. I thought it would fit perfectly underneath the TV that we put up in the corner here, or that we put up on the wall. Love that. I'm looking in the corner because I love this corner. This little stand I got for $7.99 at Goodwill. My dad actually found, he's a picker too, he found this little enamel tin. It has a like a royal blue handle on it, which matches the bed frame, which I love. So I love that little corner. I'm looking down at the floor here, just admiring those floors that were hidden underneath all that nasty carpet. So this is what that shelf looks like right now, that built-in. A lot of you guys are like, I want to see how that turned out. I think it turned out fabulous. That's the chair that was left in the house when we bought it. I just painted it in some vintage white, distressed it back. Same thing with this mirror that I got for $9.99 at Goodwill. Same thing, vintage white, distressed it. Rosie likes it. Matt contributed this cactus to the space. I love, we got that on sale as well. And he's like, you need this. I'm like, yes, I do. This is the bathroom that is just off of the bedroom. It goes with the bedroom. It's the, what would you call it? Just a bathroom that adjoins it. Love me shabby flowers, shabby florals. So I found this shower curtain on sale. I love the texture that's in it. Speaking of some shabby floors over here in this corner. This corner is so cool because you see how it has that like really cool curve in the top? It's so nice to lay in this deep bathtub that is behind that shower curtain, turn on that light in the corner, and just really have a nice relaxing bath. I have done it and it is absolutely wonderful. So I stocked this shelf here with just some towels. That little tin came from the Dollar Tree. I rolled up some face cloths into it to make it just, you know, to have them available for my guests when they come over. And then when you come out around the corner, you're gonna see that I have something here that I've not shown anybody before. Yes, do you see Sonia Miller art? These pillows are actually two of a entire pillow line that I am working on. Bloom where you want, because I don't believe that you have to bloom where you're planted. You can bloom wherever the heck you want. So watch for that. You guys are seeing the very first sneak peek of what my new pillow line will look like. I threw them into two baskets here below, just to kind of stuff them in below, which I thought looked really cool, like cactuses sticking in the baskets there. I gotta tell you, Matt picked out this TV. It has the Roku already built into it. So you can believe when there's not company here, I'm gonna be laying on that bed. Yes, admiring those glass knobs that are all throughout my home as well. But just laying back on that cozy bed and enjoying my YouTube right there on that channel. So I think it came together so nice. Of course, every room needs lots of layers of pillows. Say it with me again. This room is just so comfortable to enjoy. I love the frame that I got at a yard sale. Oh my gosh, when I look at this room, all those pieces came from all my travels. And just to kind of show you outside of the room, this is the hallway you saw in the vlog that we were working on together. Here's kind of how it adjoins. Matt found that little Moroccan style lamp. We put a fake candle in there. It flickers at night. It's absolutely beautiful in this hallway. And I'm so glad that we got through all those staples and tacks and just brought this, you know, just really showcase this floor again. This hallway feels so nice coming up at the top of the stairs. It's just absolutely beautiful. So I'm very happy with how this makeover looks. We're gonna continue here on the vlog working throughout my home. I can't wait because there are more rooms down this hallway. So I'm turning out the light here and getting ready to call it a day. Closing the door, guys. Thanks for watching, subscribing, and I'll see you guys again tomorrow. Bye.